Okay guys, we are going to continue our next lecture, that is about self-review threat. After self-interrupt threat, now we are going to study a self-review threat. What is self-review threat? Self-review threat arises when the auditor is going to review their own work previously done. Okay, it could be a accounting work or it could be a advice on assurance engagement. Okay, so this will create a self-review threat. So there are certain self-review threats: journal, other services, preparing accounting records and financial statement. As we already know that preparation of financial statement is management responsibility. So if auditor is going to prepare those financial statement, and after that he is going to check those financial statement for material misstatement, so this will arise as a self-review threat. Means there could be certain mistake that auditor during preparation of financial statement he was unable to identify it. So if in making audit of those financial statement, he can also skip those mistakes. Okay, valuation services will be there, tax services will be there, internal audit services will be there, corporate finance services will be there, and then other services and recent services with assurance client. First we are going to see recent services with audit client. For example, if an individual is a director or officer, okay, director or officer of an audit client, okay, he is in a position that he can exert significant influence for the preparation of those financial statements, okay, then he came in the audit firm and he joined the audit firm, okay, previously that individual was working with audit client that performed their services, recent services, and now he is coming to join audit firm, and in the same period he is going for audit of those financial statements. So this will create a self-review threat. Okay, if this is same accounting period, same audit period is there, then the individual should not be assigned to audit team because he recently worked with audit client. Second, okay, individual has been closely involved with the client in previous years, in previous periods, okay, you can assign him, but you have to apply certain audit safeguards. Those are what? If that person has already done work on the assignment, you have to take quality control review and you will have to discuss the matter with audit committee. Second point is coming, provision of non-audit services in general. If audit firm is going to provide certain non-audit services to their client, so can they provide these services? You have to see that scenario, that circumstances. Initially, first thing, that if the audit firm is going to provide them those services, and due to the provision of those services, it is going to create a threat to independence, and you cannot reduce this threat by applying any safeguard. So you will not provide those services, but certain non-audit services audit firm can provide if they are not going to be a threat for independence, like certain safeguards are in place. So the important thing is this: in provision of those non-audit services, auditor should not take management responsibility, okay, of client. So what is the points that are considered as management responsibility? Like, auditor should not participate in setting policies and strategic decision, directing and taking responsibility for the actions of entities employees, authorizing transactions, okay, deciding which recommendation of firm or other third parties to implement. So he will not do these responsibilities. With that, the responsibility to preparation and fair presentation of financial statements. Then second is taking responsibility for designing, implementing and maintaining internal controls. So these actions are normally considered as management responsibility. So auditor will not perform these responsibilities. Okay. Second, auditor can perform certain routine and administrative work, but in that scenario also the management has to take its own responsibility. Okay. Coming, we are coming for